U.S. President Donald Trump has blocked the purchase of a U.S. company by a Chinese one. It's a very rare step for any American president to take. Barack Obama did it just twice in his 8 years in office. In this case, the Committee on Foreign Investment in the United States, or CFIUS, had already recommended that Trump reject the $1.3 billion semiconductor deal. CFIUS reviews mergers and acquisitions of U.S. companies when there are national security concerns. The White House says the U.S. government uses programmable chips made by the semiconductor company called Lattice, and that the purchase endangers U.S. intellectual property and the nation's semiconductor supply chain. In a memo released Wednesday, U.S. President Donald Trump wrote, quote, China Venture Capital Fund Corporation Limited might take action that threatens to impair the national security of the United States. The Wall Street Journal interviewed the president and CEO of Lattice Semiconductor earlier this week. He said this, quote, you're basically saying that the government itself can't control intellectual property that they're in charge of. I don't understand that. It has to be that they don't want to do a deal with China. Now, I mentioned that Barack Obama also rejected two Chinese acquisitions here in the United States. One of them actually sued the U.S. government and won. That happened 2 years ago. The company was called Sany. And that attorney tells CGTN that that case set a precedent for other foreign companies to follow if they are similarly rejected.
I suspect in the future, if some companies, foreign companies, feel their rights infringed by the process, they can follow the roadmap laid down by this case.
There are now several other foreign direct investment deals that are also before the U.S. government that could be similarly rejected. But CFIUS attorney Stephen Heifetz does tell me this, quote, the administration is not saying we are closed off to Chinese investment. The U.S. government has cleared some Chinese cases. Jessica Stone, CGTN, Washington.